Hi lovelies, it's me, Simply Sherry, making home and entertaining simple. Thank you to all my new subscribers. I want to give you a special hi and welcome from all over the world. Thanks for joining me on this journey to making home and entertaining simple. And if you're new, hit the subscribe button. I will be showing different parts of my home in the next couple weeks because a few months back, we had a leaky toilet and it ruined the floors and walls in about 5 rooms. So it's newly renovated. Some are basic repairs and others are great repairs that I am absolutely loving. But today I'm going to show you the kitchen area right here. For those who've been with me for a while, thank you so much for your loyalty. I love all your comments. And you know that my son is now off to college and he is in a house with a couple other housemates and we gave him the kitchen table. So we finally got a new kitchen table after a few months and I'm excited to show you how we've set that up. I am standing in my kitchen and this area is the kitchen nook and that is our new kitchen table. Hi Molly. It is from Living Spaces. We got that table, a couple of the chairs, and the bench on clearance. This was actually the floor model. So it ended up being $220. And of course we paid for delivery. I think delivery is like $89. And two of these chairs were also the floor models. So they were originally $115 and they became like $32 and $35. Two of the chairs were new from the packaging. So we paid full price for that. And then the bench was $175. Who chose the table? Look at my hubby.
Me.
And he's very good at reminding us that he picked the table. He's very proud that he picked something so fabulous. If I can find the name for this table and the chairs and the bench, I'll put it in the description box below. It's kind of like a black with some brown in it. I guess it's kind of like a golden brown. I love how the chairs are low because we didn't want to block that view of the backyard and the mountains and kind of the Sonoran Desert here in Arizona. We knew we wanted to have 4 chairs and 1 bench. And so this one has a cushion. It's kind of a brown, almost a linen type of material. And I like how the legs are just kind of straight and not too thick, not too thin. That this is actually an extension and the extension fits under the table. It's fabulous. And then you can see here the bench. It could fit at least 3, maybe 4 people on this bench, which I think is great. The leg is kind of a wrought iron look. And then underneath, there's like a trough where you can store things. We always have an electric fan just to add some extra air. We do live in the desert. And then we have our Bose there. It's one of those older models because it's still an iPhone 4. But we love that there to play music and it has a remote control. And have you guys noticed that Target has their new line, which is called Project 62? I'm wondering if it's replacing the line that is called Threshold because I got a clock the other day and one was in a box that said Threshold, the other was in a box that said Project 62 and they were the exact same clock. Anyway, this is the cream and black weave table runner. It's 6 feet. So it fits exactly on the table. I normally like to have a runner go over the table a little bit, but I think this is working out great because it is sometimes cumbersome when you're sitting here and the table runner is going over. So I do like that it ends right there. I did get 4 placemats of the same style and I'm trying to get a couple more for the end spots. In the center, I have this wood platter. It does have little legs, just a metal round tray with wood in it, and I have this salt and pepper shaker. I do like to put the napkins all in the same direction so it looks a little bit neater up here. I know that's a little OCD, but that's how I do it. This candle I just picked up from Home Goods, I think just last weekend. It's called Fall Leaves. I've been looking for kind of like a cactus in concrete to put over here, but for now I went ahead and got this candle that kind of has that green color in it. These are coasters, again like a wood look from TJ Maxx, and this is what the tray looks like. So when my daughter sits here, she likes to do her homework here, And of course, this is where she sits for dinner. She just has to lift off this tray over there, grab a placemat, and then put it here. I like putting the placemats here, one, because it does match with the runner, and then two, it is put away. So to extend this table, there are locks at the bottom that he has unlatched. Then we just pull it from each end, and it has these gears that make it easier to pull. And it actually has instructions here that we need to figure out. So this is in place there, and then you just have to pull it out. Then we just push it in. Then it can be locked underneath again. That's about what, a foot and a half? And so for parties, I can use this table, push it up against the window there, and have like a buffet table. All right, so then to close it, again, pull it, make sure it's unlatched at the bottom. Pull it open. So you press down there in the middle. This has to be pushed in. Then he'll get the other side. It has to kind of come up at the same time. Then you push that one in. Again, it's easier to do it on the other side, but my husband's strong enough, he can do it from here. Then you just lay it down nicely like that. And then I'm gonna try to push and show you the gears. That was like a selling point for me, the gears. And it's really pretty smooth. And then that is unlocking it. And then this is locking it. We now call this the coffee house because we have our music there. We play coffee house music. So for me, the right piece of furniture made the space perfect. If you're new to my channel, hit that subscribe button. I'd love to have you on this journey with me to making home and entertaining simple. And I'll see you in the next one. Bye. I'm waiting long for you, so be my princess for life.